Well, thank you so much for being here. I really want to express my gratitude to the Civil Justice Laboratory, to the Center of Research of Dual Law, and to the Professor Karim Rodriguez, to the Nicolas Bernea, Valentin, and all the people that have raised me here in this beautiful university. And I would like to share with you the experience of Mexico in online dispute resolution in consumer protection. What I would like to do is, I think that this explanation could be interesting for you because you can compare the different experience between the public platform of the University de Montreal to the experience of a consumer protection agency in Mexico. So what I'd like to start is saying that the consumer protection is divided of means to things, social justice and access to the justice. The social justice is because the consumer protection is usable, has a balance between the inequity, of the enterprises and consumers' relation. And as consumer, you need to have access to justice when you have a claim or when you have a problem with a company. So to understand what happened, or to understand all the whole picture in Mexico, we need to start to speak about that Mexico is a federal republic with 32 provinces and a population of 127.7 million of people. The difference with Canada is really huge. Also, you need to understand that consumer protection in Mexico is a constitutional right. So in our constitution, it's written that every citizen has the right to have consumer protection. That's why the institution of consumer protection in Mexico is the Procuraduría Federal del Consumidor, in short way, Profeco. Profeco is divided in two big tasks. The first one is an administrative task, and the second one is the conciliation process. But the problem here is that the Profeco is an administrative authority. So, an administrative authority don't have giving power and enforcement right to comply, that make comply the agreement of conciliation process. And as administrative task, it's a great, has been doing a great job regulating the enterprises and companies for a good service for the consumers. But, well, we need to understand what is a consumer in Mexico. A consumer in Mexico is, according to the law, is a physical or moral person who acquires, performs, or enjoys a final user, goods, products, or service. This means that Profeco can be used for resolve the problems between consumers and consumers, C2C. But also, in the same law, says that we can also understand a consumer has a physical or moral person that acquires, stores, use, or consumes goods or services in order to integrate them into the process of production, transformation, commercialization, or provision of services to third parties. What means that a Profeco is, has enterprise, has company, you can go to the Profeco to resolve conflicts, like B2B conflicts. So we need to understand the general process of conciliation in Profeco. And the general process is you have you can when you have a claim, you can start a confirmation. The maximum you have 3 hearings, and if the company not attend to 1, 2, and 3 hearings, the conciliator can initiate the procedure for infringement of law. That means appeal procedure. But the problem with this appeal procedure is that the authority is going to impose a penalty fee for the companies, but it's going to be very low. So many of the huge companies prefer this penalty fee, pay the penalty fee, but not recover the amount of the consumer. By the way, you have the in the cases of B2B between companies, exists the option that you can skip all the process of conciliation and you can go directly to the arbitration. And what really happens, the option is there, but what really happens in practice is that not many of the enterprises use this step. So we can see more in detail in other graphs that I have. So Profeco have 4 kinds of conciliation process. One is the face-to-face process in the local agency. The second one is the telephone process. And the third one, the online process that is ContiliaNet, that we're going to speak about ContiliaNet and the results of ContiliaNet. And the resident process for foreign consumers who buy products in Mexico. That means that if you are a Canadian person and you are in Mexico and you buy something and you have a problem, you can go to Profeco and Profeco can attend you because you buy something in Mexico. And if you not are in Mexico, you can follow the process in Canada through the online dispute resolution process that is called ContiliaNet. So what I want to show you now is an integrated perspective. So I want to show you the experience of ContiliaNet and the Protect Operative Labs and also the lack of the consumer protection law. And I want to show you what is the criteria of the Supreme Court about the agreements of Profeco. Well, this is the ContiliaNet that says cero filas, cero espera, cero papel. That means zero paper, zero lines, and you don't need to wait. This is slogan of ContiliaNet. Well, what we see now is the big picture of ContiliaNet. Has the very beginning, ContiliaNet start like just an idea and a conception as a department in 2006. But the pilot phase of ContiliaNet start in June 3 of 2008 to December 14 of 2009. ContiliaNet start or began with 2 enterprise that was Mexican Airlines, Aeromexico, and Hewlett Packard. And then, with the time, start to increase the number of companies to buy in 6 months. And in 1 year, they have 10 enterprises more. And until now, in 2017, we have 90 enterprises. The point maximum was 98 enterprises in 2018. These are one of the examples of what enterprises has been part of the program. As I told you before, in 2008, we have a Hewlett Packard and Aeromexico. Then in 2008 and 2009, you have 3 more enterprises, has Office Depot, Volaris, that is another Mexican airline. And in 2009, you have 10 enterprises more, but you have important important companies like Telcel, Sandoz, that is a part of the Slim companies. This is an example of the platform in 2010 to 2015. And you can see, you can observe that this platform is made according with the requirements of the law, the consumer protection law act. The consumer needs to write his name, the name of the enterprise, the amount of that he reclaimed. He needs to write the description of the all the claim. He can attach the documents, the ticket, the bill to prove that he made the buy. And in 2015, the platform was renovated in order to be more easy for the consumer. And this is the process what happened. So, in the first step, the consumer is going to make the register and going to write his name and a password to into the system. He's going to identify himself with his national identity, and he also can capture the complaint, and he needs to attach the documents to prove that he made the buy. So, after that, Profeco gonna answer the date of the cancellation hearing, and after the cancellation hearing, the consumer can evaluate if he is satisfied or not satisfied with the system. But this is the internal procedure. What happened? The conciliator received the claim of the consumer, and the conciliator made the analysis and decide if the case is part or can be resolved by Profeco, because the question is applicable law or not to this case, and if is applicable, the conciliator reviews if the consumer sent all the papers, but if not apply, well, the process ends in that moment. But if the consumer have the full papers, the conciliator can send the date of the hearing. But if the conciliator considers that the consumer have a case but need to correct his papers or need more proofs, the conciliator gonna give this information to the consumer. I'm gonna say, okay, you need to correct these documents, or you need to send me more documents. And after that, the conciliator is gonna send to the consumer the final date of the hearing. And in the hearing is gonna be in asynchronic way and synchronic way. Gonna be asynchronic because the conciliator gonna help him to the telephone to make the schedule, to be secure that the people are gonna be there. But during the hearing, gonna be synchronic on the chat. And the conciliator gonna be very secure to say to the people, the lawyer of the company and the consumer, that they need to be very careful with what they say during the hearing, because everything that they say is gonna be recorded in the platform. And as a result of this record, the conciliator is gonna be a report has been at the end gonna be like the agreement. So right now, what I want to show you is the number of complaints that has been received through ConciliaNet since 9 years. So in 2008, you can observe that start with two enterprises with 169 complaints. And until now, in 2017 that you have 4,271 complaints, but of course this information of 2007 is just until the month of August. But in 2016 you have 5,382 complaints, and the maximum point is in 2015 with 6,547 complaints. So you can observe the increase of the complaints according with the increase of enterprise that's going to be part or has been part of the program. So what could you see here in this graph is in the green bar lines, you can see all the complaints that was received from Profeco, from all the process, the telephone process, the face-to-face process, the resident process. And in the little bar blue, you can see the percentage of online process to ConciliaNet. So you can observe that ConciliaNet is done with 0.2% of the process that was just two enterprises and 169 complaints. That means 2.2% of all the complaints that proceeded in Profeco. But also, you can see in 2015 that it's almost 5% of the whole complaints that proceed to Profeco, 5% are from the online dispute resolution process to consider. So, in these graphics, I want to show you in the blue line, the graphic of color, you can observe the number of complaints that increase and then present a little decrease because how explain that decrease in 2006? Because you can see in the graphic of down in the green line the number of complaints, and you can observe that in 2016 we have 84 companies, so the number of companies it's less than the other years. That is what percent decrease of the number of complaints. But also you can observe in the white cup, in the red line, the number of days of the process. And you can observe that you have the maximum point of day process in 2016 with 52 days. How we can explain that? Well, to explain it, I need to say that that little decrease in the lime green of 98 enterprises to 92 enterprises, what happened is that some of the agreements or contracts of the companies to be part of the program until then was ended. So many of the companies don't want to continue with the program. The big question is why they don't want to continue. Well, because many of the lawyers, simply consider that they prefer the face-to-face process. And this increase of days is explained because do you remember that I told you that the process of the conciliation maximum will have 3 hearings? So it's something that is related with the behavior of the companies. If the lawyers of the company doesn't want to resolve the conflict, that will make represent an increase in the days of the process, because they're gonna use the conciliation process as a delay of the final agreement or of the get agreement. So actually, another interesting day that we can see here is when the program adds new enterprises, the the days of the processes start to decrease because the new enterprises won't have this willing of make the conciliations. So what I want to show you in this graphic, that is in Spanish, all the variables are in Spanish, but what I want to show you is the second one, because the question says that what happened, do you use the system of Profeco if ConciliaNet doesn't exist? Well, the answer was that 34% of the people says that they don't use Profeco if ConciliaNet doesn't exist. So this is a big proof of the online process help to the people, to the mass of the people, to go to the access to justice. And in this graphic, I want to show you the number of arbitrations that resolve through Profeco. As you can observe, are less than the conciliation process. You have in 2006, you have three cases until 2012, that you have 98 cases. But this amount, this quantity is really, really low if you compare it with the thousands of complaints in the conciliation process. So the arbitration now is a question that the people really go, because it's tired for the consumer or the enterprise that uses the system. So we have what we learned about this are three principal subjects. The first one is the online process improves the lives of the face-to-face process. The second one is that the conciliator should be a professional degree person in law or administration or in resolve conflicts, because the conciliator should be a person to manage the behavior and the willing of the people. And it's something that in traditional process is very difficult, because for being a conciliator in the ConciliaNet or in the OBR process, you need to, the conciliator should be a professional. But in the face-to-face process, the conciliator not is needed to be a lawyer or have a degree, so that affects the quality of the conciliation process. And the third point that is very interesting is that if the people have a road to access to users, to justice, gonna be used. The people gonna be used the road that they put to access to justice. So this is very, very important.